If you're not squeamish about seeing lots of slockings, then stick around, because this is going to be fun.
So, that's the first prairie dog I've shot of the trip with my new blowguards, and you can see that the old spit viper put it right on the money, man. It killed him right there on the spot. There's two others further out here. Now, this is the beauty of the blowgun, because the others don't even know what's going on. Let's see if I can lob one out there at 20 yards and kill one of those other ones.
There's a good lesson for every prairie dog. Don't stick around after the first shot, because someone's probably reloading, and now they've got their distance.
Got him right in the head.
I'm testing the new Slockmaster Viper blowgun, and it sure proved out to be deadly.
Got him! I love my blowgun. I tell you what, shooting stuff with a blowgun is so exciting to me. It's a primitive weapon, I know, but it's deadly. And these new darts, you can see how it kills these prairie dogs right on the spot. I don't even think he got back in his hole. Watch this, I'll go out there and grab it.
So, not the best shot in the world, but for a blowgun, it's great. And they're little guys, so with my broadheads, they die quick.
Hi guys, well, I'm just getting home from Wyoming. Had a great time blowgun hunting out there and shot some stuff with my bow. That was pretty exciting, but now we're back at the old shipping headquarters, and I hired a new chick and she's pretty hot. She works for me now. The only problem is she doesn't do what she's always told, but anyway, we wanted to show you a little bit about what we got going on here. Got the new spears in. Aren't they beautiful? Wow. Exciting stuff happening at Relentless Pursuit. Carrie, you want to hold this for a second, babe? So anyway, I wanted to show you the new Slockmaster Viper. You know, we've been using the Slockmaster blowgun forever, and it's just a beautiful piece of equipment. And I've even upgraded now. I've made an even fancier blowgun, the Slockmaster Viper, and put a pistol grip on there, so you can get those beautiful steady shots. And I've got a mouthpiece that's suited better for an adult mouth, and a polished inside barrel, so the speed of your dart is faster and more accurate, I believe. So what a beautiful piece of equipment. Comes in a breakdown model, so you can throw it in your suitcase with camouflage. So man, we got some cool stuff coming out. And this is also a big bore, same size as the Slockmaster blowgun, and shoots the big bore darts. Now, speaking of darts, it comes with the new Slockmaster big game razor darts. And look at that. Aren't those beautiful? Man, I'm proud of those. They're really, really sharp. And that's what I used on these prairie dogs. So we're going to take a moment now and go back to hunting prairie dogs, but I wanted to just show you what's going on. And if you'd like to order a blowgun, we got lots of them for you. We got spears, we got new hats, you name it. And I even got a hot shipping girl now that'll ship them to you. So hopefully if you get a chance, you can jump on slockmaster.com and check out the new blowgun, new blow darts, spears, and all kind of fun stuff like new hats. And heck, you might even get a look at my new shipping girl.
the springtime is a great time. This is turkey season now, so it's a good time to hunt prairie dogs because you get the family colonies coming out. There might be four or five of them sitting on top of their hole. And the young ones are usually the dumb ones, and they're the ones you get the close shot at. So, but I got my Oneida in the back. I see a big one sitting out there.
It looks like he's about a long shot. So, but
let's take a shot at him with the bow. We're using the old farmer trick. Now, this isn't possible to shoot prairie dogs where they hammer on them with guns all the time because they get really wise. They're survivors. But in this little location here, we're really far off the roads. And this is an old farm that's been here for years where they've cattled and worked their cattle. So there's cattle out here with them and the farmers come and go. So if you want to hunt with a blowgun or a bow, this is the kind of place you want to go hunt prairie dogs. Even better is if you're in a city limit somewhere where there's prairie dogs or near houses because they're used to people. And on the day you show up, it's the element of surprise. So I'm going to go get my arrow and we'll move on to the next spot. So they're very cool looking animals, and you can see why the snakes and the birds and the coyotes and the badgers all love them. They're meaty little guys. Every hole is full of them. I mean, not one, not two, but listen. He'll be coming up later, I'll slock him too, but anyway, I got two. I shot this one and shot a little one off the hip. Look at the blood blown all over the top of the thing. The Grim Reaper seems to do a better job because it stops them, but the blunts knock them dead too, but they take your arrow in the hole sometime. But, all right, look at that one sitting on his hole over here about 35 yards right to my left. I'm going to take a shot from right here. So I knocked that sucker cold. The Grim Reaper went right through and went on by and he fell down in the hole. I bet when the other ones were sitting in the hole looking up, they're like, oh my goodness. All right. Oh, broke his back. That's not a very big target at 25 yards, especially when they're at 50, but those, these arrows fly good, man. I went to four fletching. I don't know if y'all shoot four or three, but these four fletched arrows are wicked, man. They've really helped. They true your shot up a little bit. All right, I got one sitting out here now and another arrow between me and him. That's a bonus.
The prairie dogs are treated much like we treat rats and mice back home. Poison and other drastic measures are often used to eliminate the entire colony. This town is lucky, for my friend Dave Nelson guides hunters, guys like me who like to hunt them, and we'll pay to do it. So it puts value on the prairie dogs. As a result, they let the town live. It's an example of how hunting actually puts back more wildlife than it takes. The few that I shoot will have little effect over the town. But Dave's cats, the foxes, and the coyotes will all enjoy what we leave for them to eat. Once again, it's a prime example how hunters are part of the cycle of life.